out, dot, dot, dot. Financial peace it out. Ding, 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 cha-ching. Money. Let's talk money. What's the first thing that comes to your mind when you think about money? For most people, I think the topic of money brings up anxiety. Unfortunately, in a culture where we are consumerists and we buy to fill a need, we wonder at the end of the month where our money went. And I know that for us to be true. And being a single income, money is tight. And I'm going to be honest with you because I'm real. Is that it's always been a topic of discussion in our home. Arguments and frustrations, and you and your spouse tend to be one or the other. The spender or the saver. Well, for me, I don't know if you know, I'm the spender. But I'm a thrifty spender, and I try to justify it by saying, but I got this for $2 and this and this and this. Honestly, it came to a point this year where we are reevaluating our budget and thinking about future goals. When you think of peace and money, most of the time, people don't think they go together. I don't know if any of you have heard it, but it's an amazing program. It's Financial Peace University by Dave Ramsey. It's a faith-based program about money, and ultimately, money doesn't have to control us, but that we not can control our money, but we can tell our money where to go. This program, you can experience peace and freedom. It's a hard topic, but I promise it's worth it. So I just wanted to share with you what Josh and I have been going through for the last, I think it's been 8 weeks now. It's a total of 9 week program. We finish up next week, which is a bummer, but it's been an amazing program for us. What Financial Peace University, if you don't know, I also put a link below. It's a $100 kit, which you're like, wait, this is supposed to be about money and I have to pay money? Yes. So you get this kit for $100 and it usually is someone who leads the program with other people, and you watch the videos from Dave Ramsey and then you apply it to everyday life, as well as you work through the workbook, and they give you a website to log into and give you so many tools on how to help you. And honestly, it has been a little bit of a frustrating experience, only because it's called discipline and it's called working on where our money goes. And honestly, the first thing they have you do is figure out your budget and what you spend on it every month. And Josh and I looked over our budget for the last couple months before we started this in February last month. And honestly, it was gut-wrenching. Realize, how did we get in this situation? We had a budget but weren't sticking to it. Like most of us, we don't stick to it. Or most of us don't save money because we don't have money to save. And going to this program, like, how are we supposed to save when we barely can make our budget every month? Thank God that He provides. The money isn't ours. The money is God's first. And how can we use our money as a vessel to bless other people instead of hoard it for ourselves? And that was convicting to me. So I wanted to read one of the things that talked about the secret to saving money. And I thought this was really good. It says, most people don't save like they know they need to. Why? Because they have competing goals. The goal to save isn't a high enough priority to delay that purchase of the pizza, the DVD player, the new computer, or the china cabinet. So they purchase, buy, and consume all their dollars away, or worse, go into debt to buy these things. We live in such a culture where we need to have things. And my favorite and above quote all from Dave Ramsey is, live like no one else now, so later on you can live like nobody else. Meaning, live smart, live barely making it through, but pay your bills and save, and later on you can live like nobody else with no debt, with no shame, with being able to give. And honestly, that's where our heart is as a married couple, is we want to give. But when the money comes in, it's so hard to give tithe first, it's so hard to give it away. But when we give it away, it's so much more blessing back to us than ever to hold on to it. I kind of want to just give you the basic things Dave Ramsey tells you to do. Is the first thing is to save $1,000 up. And I'm like, how do you do that? And he talked about selling that bike or selling this, selling that, whatever it means to get the $1,000, and that's an emergency fund. The second thing that he asks you to do is the debt snowball, which I don't know if any of you heard that. It's amazing. It talks about your smallest debts first, so on until you get to your biggest debt at the bottom. So third thing is try and save, which just could take years, which it will for us, 3 to 6 months of what your monthly expenses are. And that is another kind of bigger savings emergency fund for you. Then after that, number four is invest 15% of your household into an IRA or a pre-retirement plan. Five is save for your children's college. Six, pay off your house early. Seven, build wealth and give. So those are just the steps. I'm not giving you into it because I want you to go through the program. Just me telling you is not nearly enough. And honestly, it's been so good for our marriage. I love that financial piece has kind of been the counselor, the third party, and showing us how we can be smart. But ultimately, to understand that money doesn't have to control us. When it controls us, we are not honoring God with that. A lot of people think money is the root of all evil. No, the love of money is. That before anything else, before people, before giving, is the root of evil. It's been a heart and a gut and everything check for me and for us, but it's been so good. So I recommend to you, look up where you can find a financial peace university in your town. And honestly, it was kind of hard for me to share this with you because we live very frugal, but we're happy and we have lots of love. But we hope that we live like no one else so that someday we can give like no one else. I can give now, but I want to give in abundance, and I want to teach my daughter healthy view of money and that to honor God with our money and to honor one another. And so I just want to share that with you. I'm going to be like dramatic, but it will change your life for the better. It will get your priorities in check and on the same team for you and your family. So, when in doubt, signing out. Sorry, I'm dancing. Comes with what you get. Excuse me. Burp.